Revolutionary Volume 2. Yeah. Broadcasting live from Harlem, New York. Let the truth be known. You better watch what the fuck flies out of your mouth, or I'ma hijack a plane and fly it into your house. Burn your apartment with your family tied to the couch and slit your throat so when you scream, only blood comes out. I doubt that there could ever be a more wicked MC, cause AIDS-infested child molesters are even sicker than me. I see the world for what it is, beyond the white and the black, the way the government downplays historical facts. Cause the United States sponsored the rise of the Third Reich, just like the CIA trained terrorists how to fight, build bombs and sneak box cutters onto a flight. When I was a child, the devil himself bought me a mic, but I refused the offer, cause God sent me to strike with skills unused like fallopian tubes in a dike. My words will expose George Bush and Bin Laden as two separate parts of the same seven-headed dragon. And you can't fathom the truth, so you don't hear me. You think Illuminati's just a fucking conspiracy theory? That's why conservative racists are all running shit, and your phone is tapped by the federal government. So I'm jamming frequencies in your...
Right, hello, how we doing? Hail, hail. Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, wherever you're on the planet, because I know everybody is spread out. The Celtic family is truly worldwide, global. Truly worldwide and global, and you join me here tonight. Niall Boylan, Flegs Fraser, Bin by Group. Yes, Flegs Fraser, maybe that's why I didn't want to answer last night, but anyway, we digress, we move us upwards, and here we go. Right, good evening, good afternoon, wherever you are. That was the first call. First call, no response. Do you think that person could call back? Do you think so? Do you think it's possible? What time is it now? If you try to do this show for the last 40 minutes, can you believe it? I'm going to do this for 40 minutes. Try to get a feed out of broadband, try to get a Wi-Fi feed going. I'm doing this in my dongle, having gave up and trying to get a feed. And right, do you ain't got any phone back? How long will we give it? 2 minutes? Half a minute? Not one more nanosecond. We're on the phone again, so we've got this number. The cat did a pedo. Hello, old chap. Right, two down. How many more shall we go? Let me see. Two down. And sorry about that. Oops. Just a quick show anyway. This is just a quick show. We live in hope. We live in hope. And has anybody got word of Lord Nimble Smith? Must be bad news. A speculator has said that it must be bad news because we would have heard about it now.
Welcome to the O2 message.
And that's, if we were playing baseball, that would be 3-0, we'd be off there. We had 3 strikes. 3 strikes, we're out, we're gone. It's a hard knock life. Do 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 do. It's a hard knock life. You gotta take the rough with the smooth, you gotta take the ups and the downs. You gotta roll with it. And that's 3-0. Now most people would just crawl up and say, oh, come away, no more. In reality, so should I. But I don't take a refusal as time to go home. I see it as a challenge to be find someone who we can talk to be find someone who we can wind up, to be get a zombie that we can annoy. The bull parrot was giving it to me tight earlier on. Oh, last night, I was going to do a show last night, as I said. I was all ready to phone the Singapore Slingers. And then as I was having chat, I just seen on the timeline, it was all kicking off in the Dow for this thing with the promissory note night. Yes, the Irish economy would be sold down the river. Only the other family stuff the day I went for a kip. Sometimes my 4 or 5 hours sleep, I think I was talking about that last night, my 4 or 5 hours sleep, well sometimes it catches up on you, you need to go for a double dose of it, so I had a 4 hour sleep, and then once I did the weigh-ins, I had another 4 hour sleep, so took me right out of the game for the rest of the day, and then there was a wee panic with my out of the weigh-in, so. Aye, and so it was all kicking off in the Dow last night, and I was going to do a show. I ended up sitting watching all these crackpots in the Dáil talking about what was going on. Only a few of them were talking sense. Jerry Anadam's amongst them, and another few other people saying it was the end of democracy. These crackpots are not phoning back. Fucking shite bags, a lot of them, aren't they? Shite bags. That's what we're dealing with here. Aye, so that's why, but I ended up, I phoned, and I got a phone call about 12:30 on an unknown number, like a phone call back my Skype, so it could have possibly been them, could have possibly been them, because I left a message when I phoned last night. I did a show, and actually the show I did last night, if anybody's heard it, I phoned through to the Taoiseach's office in Ireland, would you believe it, after it had been done. I spoke to the secretary, and then after speaking to the secretary to try to get me through, I phoned up, I went and dug the number out myself, phoned the number, and somebody kept picking it up. Some shitebag kept picking it up, and no wanting to speak. I phoned them with about 5 different numbers, and they finally relented, and picked the fucking thing up, and went, hello? And I was like, Edna Kenny? He's like, no, and I'm like, it is. So if anybody's a voice expert, if you think that was Edna Kenny, because that was meant to be his office. So I try to get through to Edna Kenny to call him a fucking douchebag. Excuse the language. An absolute douchebag. Hey, here, look, I've got this number. Let's see if this works out. He's been through a lot. This crackpot. I wonder if he's... You know, it's Lodge Night tonight, isn't it? It's Lodge Night.
The number you have dialed cannot accept this call. Please hang up and try again later. The number you have dialed...
Giovanni Di Stefano's number has went for a button. Right, let me see. So yeah, I was going to do a show last night and phone our Singapore Slingers. So I get delayed to about 3:30, 4 in the morning. I did the show then. So it's on there, it's there if anybody wants a wee listen to it. Right. Let me see who we got here. We're digging out the phone book. Right, here's someone here. We try to get a hold of this crackpot for a while. It rings out. What can we do? This wasn't the one I was looking for here, this wasn't the one. Well, we've got this number here. Before we take this number off and try someone else, We'll try this.
Please press 1 if you wanted to send a text to the person you are.
So let's see. Bear with me. We're gonna get someone. Keep the faith. Calm down, sweetie. Get a mellow buds. Chill out with a Cinzano, whatever. No, don't chill out with a non-alcoholic Cinzano. Just chill the feck out. Calm down. These things take time. Come on. Where's my phone in here now? Fuck my phone.
This is the Vodafone voicemail service for.
What time is it in Singapore anyway? Well, that's too early to phone Singapore, isn't it?
This is the vote of.
It's no man eight and eight, Troop says. No man eight and eight. What is going down here? This is a different number. This is a fresh number. They should be lapping this number up some of these crackpots. These crackpots, if you've seen this number coming through, they should be biting it. They'd be going like that. Whoa. We get a call for the head office here. Pantalone, so it is. Nobody's here. Nobody's in. Right, we're going transglobal now. We're jumping on a ferry. Going ferry further than across the Mersey. We're going Atlantic. We're going right across the Atlantic here. Here we go. We need to change the number. Right, we'll give them the straight out of Compton number. Just in case they don't like the UK calling. We'll get the Compton number on the go here. Come on. Come on, computer. Let's go. Come on, right, we're almost there, come on, way up. We'll change the number. One of the most horrible things with this Skype, with the numbers, when you take a UK, guess what comes up in front of you? Guess what for the UK? Bastard and Butcher's Apron. Now I've chosen a Yankee one, it gets worse. Get the Stars and Stripes. Kill me. Hey, look at this, my man. He's in the same area code as me. This man's in the same, he's in my same area code. We're straight out of Compton or something like that. I'm straight out of Compton with this crackpot. Here we go. 9310. That's the area code. That's me. I've got that code. 38. Right, let's see what's happening here. Gotta get somebody on here. Come on. Yes. USA, California, A style. Here. Yep. Yes, my man. Come on. Somebody pick up the fucking phone. We only got 15 minutes left. Come on, we need an answer. Somebody. I'm phoning Snoop Dogg's agent. We might speak to Snoopy Doggy. Snoop Lion. Anybody, somebody help me out here, right? Get me numbers down. Supporters clubs down in Australia. G'day, Struth. Supporters clubs, Rangers supporters club down in Australia. Melbourne, Perth, Brisbane. Melbourne, Perth, Brisbane. Go, please. Right, Snoop Dogg is my fucking dance here. Right, now we need to You change that number back. The same code there, how's that? 310, same code. Right, we're back in it, we're going the. We don't want it now, we'll just cancel this, we don't want it no more. Deactivate. Take the caller ID off. Here we go.
Helen, I'm sorry, but the person you've called.
Come on. That's me done. I'm a busted flush. Every number that I'd intended to go. Do you want to know the people I phoned there? Well, that was Willie Fraser, and I phoned other high profile crackpots in my phone involved with the Sevco. No saying any names, but not one picked up. So hit me with it. Hit me with your river. Give me your numbers, because I'm out of fresh meat here. I can't be. Somebody give me a number in Australia, down under. Melbourne, Tim, God bless you, Mochara. What have we got down here? Fuck Snoop, we want the parrot back. We'll be getting one later. This is just a quick show. This is just a quick phone out show. I was trying to get some crap pots on there. I was wanting to go and wind up. I had different voices all sorted and all that. I was going asking for my money. I was going to look for some investment. Right, we're getting this here. We're going Melbourne styling. Who's this? Melbourne Loyal. Can't find Melbourne Loyal. Ray, have I spoke to him? What the fuck, I've not spoke to him. I remember I spoke to him from these crackpots, but what one have I spoke to? The Brisbane one, he said, the Brisbane, I tried to speak to the Coastal Mariners, I spoke to him last night. Right, anybody, wait till I check over my hymen there, so where have I got, am I changing it, we're going to Australia. Right, I'm sure I spoke to that name rings a fecking bell there, by the way. What club is that, Faye? Where's he, Faye? Because that name rings a bell. I can't remember. I've spoke to that many different ones. Right, let's see. Hold on. The Mergo Selvin, but I'm sure I've spoke to that. Sure I've spoke to him. Early morning, Australia. Oft. It's a bit too early in the morning, isn't it? Aye, I know. We're going too early in the morning, we went USA, but here look, oh it's a shambles, this is cash and carry, the parrot would say, get the parrot on, is that what we're saying, are we getting that f***ing cheater on? We can get him on later on, we'll get him on later on, right, hold on, look, if at first, should we just phone David Murray, will we just get all Minty Boys on, will we go for that crackpot? Say we've got a whistleblower. We have a whistleblower here, Mr. Murray. You're claimed. You're fucking. Right, it's two things, mate. Right, we'll go to the Irish president. What was the man's I was doing last night? Where's these numbers? Right, let's see. Last night, Irish president. Where are the fuckers? That was the man there. Here we go. Straight through. So I guess. Here we go. El Presidente. The T-Shock. That's the T-Shock, isn't it? Same old, isn't it? Now last night when I phoned, Somebody picked up and shot it. Somebody picked up and shot it. Who was that person? Let's see, 4-0, 4-1-2-3, that was the number there. Invalid number. Oh. Horrible, horrible noise. That's that. See, we got one here. Phone Australia later on. Well, too early for Australia. Can't be bothered waking people up out of their beds.
Don't like that.
I'll record a message at the tone. When you are finished, hang up or stay on the line for further options.
Right. Invalid number, invalid number. We're getting nobody. We're getting a blank here. We've shot a duck here. We're shooting a duck. Right. Any suggestions? Any more? Phone Lena Martell. They will be closed. It's 8:45. The Imperial Bar in Melbourne is chat. You're kidding me on. Is that where he is? Melbourne Tim, where it, hit me with your number. Teammate, I'm wanting the lowdown, mate. I want the lowdown. I need the full lowdown. What hotel? Give me the hotel. Whereabouts is he? Please, Melbourne Tim, hit me up. Where are you? Give me your number. Fact, Melbourne Tim, I've got your number. You phoned me, ain't you? What's your number? I've got you on here. I'm saved you. I'm sure I've saved you. Oh, my goodness. Where are you? You must be here. I'm sure you're here if I saved you. If not, let's see, hold on, that, do you know what I've done, because these might be some of the numbers that's, I never managed to save, the names, 6-1, isn't it, 6-1, is it 6-1, I've got a number here, save 61922, is that your number, 61922, Melbourne Tim, 61922, I've got a 6-1, see, I don't know what happened to these. I meant to save some of these numbers. Some of them, I think that was yours. I think I tried to save it. Did I put it here? Did I save it? No, because I've got... Unless I saved it on your... Willie Fraser, my good friend Willie Fraser, he's not picking up the phone anymore. He's not picking up the phone up anymore, and he's lost his job as a flag spokesman. Fly the flag, Willie, fly the flag. Anybody got the DUP offices, the UUP offices, anybody got the offices of Loyalists? Want to speak to Loyalists? Any Loyalists? You get Loyalists? Moncton? Who's this Moncton? Richard, are you there, Richard? Tell us who this Moncton is. Moncton, anybody got a Moncton number? Right, where are we going with this, right? Yeah, where are we going? I've had to close all this stuff down so as I could... On the show, what have we got? The parrot has my Skype. I don't have a Skype number. No, it's not a number. Did I phone you? No, it's another boy I phoned. It was a boy in Sydney. Shit, I'm getting you. Sorry, I'm getting you confused with the boy out in Sydney, Melbourne Tim. Sorry. No, well, has parrot got it? Right, okay, I'll get it off him. No, was it? I thought it was you who'd phoned me before, but I'm confused with the boy, the Tim over in Sydney. Jim, I think it is his name. So yeah, I would get you confused there. Move on, Tim. Yeah, no, well, I was wanting to get the full lowdown. If you've got the stuff there, keep it stooming on, mate. And if I get a chance, I'll get your number off the parrot, and I'll get your Skype name off the parrot, and I'll phone you in a wee bit. Once we're finished here, I'll phone you. You can give me the lowdown, mate. If you know anything else, you're the man. We want Chuckles. We want the main man, Chuckles. So you're doing it later tonight. So what's that? Is that morning time, our time, then? Oft. I'm up early in the morning then, let's get it gone. Let's get it gone. Old Chuckles Vision. Maybe I'll speak to you soon then, bro. But right, anybody got anything at all? Where we going with this? We need a number. Somebody give me a number. 5 minutes, even if I get somebody. You know the way I talk, I'll be talking for Scotland and Ireland. And where am I going here? I'm putting in Twitter. Has anybody got anything on Twitter for me? Anything on Twitter? I'll put this up. Right, God willing, then we'll do a show then, back at 1. Heading to bed early night, going for a 2 o'clock finish, so we'll try to do a show about 1 o'clock. Let's see, online is Snoop Records, who's this? 800, where'd you get that for you? Oh, that one, I listened to that, the one with Dave. I'll get it sorted, Devil's Advocate. Get me some numbers, Devil's Advocate. If you're listening to this, where's my numbers? Get your finger out. You are shocking. It's been a year since you got me a decent number. Alright, maybe a wee bit less, but is it the ultimate decent number? What is going down? You're getting sacked as my Devil's Advocate, you. Yeah, shyster. Right, we got Dumb Schmuck. Snoop Dogg Dogg. What kind of number is that you've posted here? Edo, sort your numbers out. What kind of number is that? See, see when it all blew up in the thing a few weeks ago? I did a chase to his phone and all sorts, so it might not be his record company anymore, but that number looks like a dodgy one. That one, you'll get no chance for that one, mate. We'll not get through anywhere with this, mate. We get through with us. I'm about 209. Might do. Here we go. Not enough numbers, you crackpot. And phone number. Sort that out. Sort that one out. You no go to it right at all there, Edo. You have no go to it right there at all. Lord Monckton, who invents it. We're going to get his a number for him. Rich, what's good is this? Right, see the next person to say, phone this person without a number. You're going to have to take a jump off an auto step. You're going to have to get a pants down thrashing or something. By Lady Gaga. The feck is this? Don't say phone this person unless you've got a number to go with it. How frustrating is that? It's like saying, here you go. Eat this. You're sitting there hungry. Eat this big chicken. Fucking meal. Well, where is he? Get it gone. I'm sitting here, Hank Marvin. And you don't bring it here. So don't name to give me a name unless you've got a fucking number. I don't take names unless you get numbers. Somebody sent me a DM. Somebody gave me a number. It's too late. We're too late now, right? These are too late. I've tried everybody. It's just too late. I'll do a phone-in show later on so you can phone in. I'm away. I've got stuff to do now. What's going down? Who sent me something? Somebody. Oh. You've got his personal email address. Who have you just sent us there? What is it with this? I'm sure I've spoke to that Newell. I'm sure I've spoke to him. I'm pretty sure I've spoke to that Ray Newell. I need to find the site, but he just sent me the same man as the parrot and the other brother sent us. Loads more here. That's the man. I know that's the man. I'll check it out. Look at this. Green's mother to try and get a hold of, mate. I can give you his personal... Give me it then, right? You fucking can't even get your number. You're slipping up, by the way. You're well slipped up. The Devil's Advocate. Not the shyster from Italy, the kid on one I'm talking about. The real man for the huddle board. He's winding me up here. He's having a giraffe. Last year, he could get major numbers now. He's just offering emails address. What good's that to me? I give me the email address or phone up the email address. Hi, email address. Fucking good is that? Right. So it's an all points bulletin. Where is Chuckles? We went Chuckles. He's in Melbourne tonight. It's Melbourne tonight, so that's the morning. What hotel is he in? Have you got a hotel? Have you got a hotel? Is it middle of the night time? Is it morning time? Give me a hotel for Chuck. He must be just getting up now. This is prime time. Melbourne, what are they, 12, 13 hours? So he must be getting up out of scratcher now. Somebody get me a hotel in Melbourne, right? I'll come back, I'll do a show. If anybody get numbers hotel in Melbourne, we'll post another show. So we got a number for hotel. Anybody get any point of reference, wherever Chuckles is, hotel, Yankee Foxtrot, and we'll be back in 10. What's this here? Who's posted this? Tweets daily. Who's he doing? There's only two gym trainers. No matter how much Charles Green's attempts to dress it up with a new club. What's this jacket? Yes, well done. That was a brilliant one there. We'll need to get that retweeted here. We'll get this retweeted. Fuck me, Jabba the Hun is a two-faced bastard. Tell us something we doesn't know. Right. Hasta la vista then, people. I'm sorry. I've tried. A half an hour show. That's what I said I would do. A wee quick half hour show. We still doing it? Are we stopped? Is this stopped? What's going on? It's all frozen here. It's got another one. We're past a half an hour. Look, you crackpots. We're into overtime here. Who just get a bite of a set? Who? What'd you get with him? Right. Okay, troops, right. I'm sorry, I did try. Not one of them phone back. Not one of those shite bags that I would phone back, yeah? Not one of those douchebag numpties. Well, in the meantime, I'm away to listen to my favourite nighttime listener at this time, Niall Boylan, 4 Hits FM. Anyone listen to it? Niall Boylan. Quite a good show. Last night, a brother there just posted a call, I think. I'm sure it's got to be the call. From a guy, Dave, who was on saying that he cheated his wife, and then all of a sudden, the friend of the wife phones in. I think that's what it's up there now. I think that's what you've got into, right? So it's Classic Hits. I'll post you the link. Classic Hits. ClassicHits.ie. Classic Hits. So yeah, I'm going to go and do what I need to do here. And I'll go and tune in, see what they're talking about. I phoned earlier on at the start of the week about, I think it was legalising drugs and such like. So I'll go and tune in. Wait to tune in and out, so I'll post it if I'm going to be appearing on there. Oh, look at these mad dafties. Hold on, you might have some action, see what they're saying. Some mad daft zombie lassies, man, and with a zombie tap on. I'm gonna see what they're saying, right? Okie dokie, okie chokie, right? I'll post that on there on the time, mate. I'll just post on my Twitter. Classic Hits, I'm about to listen to that now. Right, I'll speak to you all soon, God willing. I'll do a wee show about 1 o'clock. What? That's an amazing show, what are you talking about? Should phone up. What are they talking about, Edo? What are they talking about? Edo, what are they talking about? Quick, come on, hurry up. What are they talking about? Get me up to speed. If you're listening to that now, tell me. I'll roll the phone up, mate. They're nice. Put me on, mate. That Niall Boylan's a good guy. Tell me, Edo. Come on, Edo. Put it up there. Tell me what they're talking about, then I'll close this down. We're just waiting this brother now. Come on, Edo. It's an amazing show, they're talking about it on Classic FM. Should phone up. I will phone up if you tell me what it is. Give me a hint, Edo, give me a hint, and then we're out of here. Give me a hint.
in your brain when you speak to me. Technique, a rip a rapper to pieces indecently. Pack weapons illegally, cause I'm never hesitant. Sniper scoping a commission, controlling the president.
The next piece of evidence you're about to see is the biggest smoking gun of them all. President George W. Bush signed Presidential Decision Directive W199I, telling FBI agents as well as defense intelligence officers that if they tried to stop Al-Qaeda, they would be arrested under national security implications. It's been in every publication from the Wall Street Journal to the Washington Times. Actual lawsuits have now been filed by FBI agents who are outraged by the fact that they were not allowed to stop Al-Qaeda. The global crime syndicate that George W. Bush and his family fronts for has everything to gain from the September 11th attacks. A national ID card, a national control grid, a cashless society. It's part of the public record. George Bush signed the documents, threatening defense intelligence and FBI agents with arrest if they stopped Al-Qaeda. This is the most absolutely treasonous, treacherous thing he could possibly do. George Bush is a mass murderer.
Father, forgive them, for they don't know right from wrong. The truth is set you free, written down in a song. And the song has the cause of death written in code. The word of God brought to light that'll save your soul.
Save your soul, motherfucker. Save your soul. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I hacked the Pentagon for self-incriminating evidence of Republican manufactured white powder pestilence. Marine Corps flak vest with the guns and ammo, spitting bars like a demon stuck inside a piano. Turn a Sambo into a soldier with just one line. So hear the truth about the system that'll fuck up your mind. They gave Al-Qaeda $6 billion in 1989 to 1992, and now the last chapters of Revelations are coming true. And I know a lot of people find it hard to swallow this, cause subliminal bigotry makes you hate my politics, but you act like America wouldn't destroy two buildings in a country that was sponsoring bombs dropped on our children. I was watching the towers, and though I wasn't the closest, I saw them crumble to the earth like they were full of explosives. And they thought nobody noticed the news report that they did about the bombs planted on the George Washington Bridge. Four non-Arabs arrested during the emergency, and then it disappeared from the news permanently. They dubbed the tape of Osama, and they said it was proof. Jealous of our freedom, I can't believe you bought that excuse. Rocking a motherfucking flag don't make you a hero. Word to ground zero. The devil crept into heaven. God overslept on the 7th. The new world order was born on September 11th.
Father, forgive them, for they don't know right from wrong. The truth is set you free, written down in a song. And the song has the cause of death written in code. The word of God brought to light that'll save your soul.
Save your soul, motherfucker. Save your soul.
And just so conservatives don't take it to heart, I don't think Bush did it, cause he isn't that smart. He's just a stupid puppet taking orders on his cell phone from the same people that sabotaged Senator Wellstone. The military industry got it popping and locking, looking for a way to justify the Wolfowitz doctrine. And as a matter of fact, Rumsfeld, now that I think back, without 9/11, you couldn't have a war in Iraq or a defense budget of world conquest proportions. Kill freedom of speech and revoke the right to abortion, tax cut extortion, a blessing to the wealthy and wicked. But you still have to answer to the Armageddon you scripted. And Dick Cheney, you fucking leech, tell him your plans about building your pipelines through Afghanistan and how Israeli troops train the Taliban in Pakistan. You might have some house niggas fooled, but I understand colonialism is sponsored by corporations. That's why Halliburton gets paid to rebuild nations. Tell me the truth, I don't scare into paralysis. I know the CIA saw Bin Laden on dialysis in 98 when he was top 10 for the FBI. Government ties is really why the government lies. Read it yourself instead of asking the government why, cause then the cause of death will cause the propaganda to die.
Father, forgive them. They do know what they're doing. I'm not forgiving them. Fucking, what's happening here? What are we doing? What are we doing here? Hold on, we'll just get incoming news here. Thank you, all the Celtic family. All the way from Big Apple. Let's see if we open it. Oh, I've pressed the button to open it. I've pushed it back. There we go, it's opening. Thank you very much, thank you very much. Edo, where are we going? Can't you find one number for the Melbourne City Royal? Only an email address. So that's where they are. But the hotel, we're looking for a hotel. Do you even know the hotel they're in? We want to get a hotel for them now. Did you? We'll go high class. How many five-star class hotels? Is that where he stays in Melbourne? There's look, there can't be many five-star hotels, right? Every that's what I'm doing. Every number, what we got here? Rangers. Who's sending this? Who's this? Where'd you get this for? What's this for? Where's this for? I'm only looking at this on my phone, so... It's not opening well, I need to put it on my thing, man. Right, I've just found a new... Right, here we go, look at this, this comes with all the numbers. Richard Blumenthal. Right, now, I've just moved in to the United States Senate for some numbers here. So here we go. Eyes down for a full house. Alexander Lamar, Avik Kelly, Tammy Baldwin, John Barroso, Max Baucus, Mark Bielik, Michael Bennett, Gordon Bennett. No, Gordon Bennett, just Michael Bennett. Richard Blumenthal. Oh, he's top of the list, right? So we're going for Blumenthal. I love that name. Roy Blunt. Oof. Roller Blunt, my man. John Boozman. What the hell's going on here? Barbara Boxer. Sherrod Brown. Richard Burr. Maria Cantwell. Benjamin L. Carden. Thomas Carper. Robert P. Jr. Robert P. Casey Jr. Saxby Shambliss. Oof. Daniel Coates, Tom Coburn, Thad Cochran, Susan Cotton, have we ever going to get a name that we could, Christopher A. Coons, who's getting down here, Bob Corker, John Cornvin, William Cowan, Mike Crapple, right, so we get Mike Crapple, Ted Cruz, Joe Donnelly, so what time are we talking about, 5 o'clock, Diane Feinstein, Michael Enzi, Richard Dublin, Deb Fisher, Jeff Flake, Al Franken. And we have a winner. Roll up, roll up. We are now talking to Al Franken. He's a Democrat. He's a dumb schmuck and a puppet. He's getting spoken to. Let's bring on the Al. Can we get to speak? No, after 40 minutes. We've only made the 30-minute show, but since I've no talked to any fecker, surely to goodness, a Yankee Doodle Dafty is going to put me out of my misery.
Senator Al Franken's office.
Hello there. Is Senator Al Franken's office? Can I speak to him, please?
He's not available. Can I take a message?
Yes, I'm Tommy Gold from Glasgow Radio Online. I don't know if you're aware, but... We're calling here from the UK. Is Mr. Franken available for a chat at any point?
Oh, hold on one moment.
Oh, here we go. Yes, there we go. Now we're talking.
He's not in. Would you like to leave a voicemail with our press secretary?
No, but is there a chance that I could be able to speak to Al at some point in the future to get some words of wisdom for our UK listeners?
If you'd like to leave a voicemail with our press secretary, I'm sure she could get back to you.
Yeah, no problem. How do I do that?
One moment.
Hello?
Thank you. Hi, you reached Alexandra Fedosoff with Senator Franken's office. Please leave me a message and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. I can also be reached on my cell at 202-713-8450. Thank you.
So we like a cell phone. Yeah, she sounds nice. Look at this. This is good. We can get straight through to the Secretary of Senators of the USA. Now we're talking. Was that 202? We're on 202. Aye, we're on 202. 713. Hold on. Before I do this, what I need to be doing is changing my number. I better be getting my Compton number. Let's get my Compton number displayed. That's what it's all about. Where are we going? Let's get Compton. Straight out of Compton to be, keep it up for the last time. No, we put Black Ops UK one. United States. Click of a button. Now we're phone out. This Skype is just... That's just amazing. Here we go. Phone out of Compton. Let's go. Was her name Alexander or something?
Your call has been forwarded to an automated.
Right, let me see. She didn't answer the call from Compton. Maybe she's a bit funny that way. Let's see. We're now phoning from London. Let's see if she picks up a London number. Do. Oh well, maybe she's away getting back, but old Al. Oh, maybe Al's showing her how to work in an internship. Maybe she's getting interned now. We don't know. Look at this guy here. We need to get a hold of this guy. Look, I like his name, Chuck Grassley. We want a Chuck. I finally spoke to somebody. Can we believe it? But alas. It ends up ringing out to the next call. So a shocking run. 1 for 20 I think we've got here. Shocking strike rate tonight. Shocking. It's used crackpots. You're all feckin' Jonas. Fucking jinxes. Look at the time here. Half an hour show. One person. Don't ever any of yous come back this way again to put a jinx on me.
Senator Grassley's office.
Oh, hi, I'm phoning to speak to Chuck, please.
Senator Grassley's currently in a meeting right now. Could I take down a message and pass it along to him for you?
Yes, my name's Thomas J. Clark. I'm phoning from the BBC in the UK.
Okay.
And I was wanting to get Mr. Grassley on for a chat about the fiscal deficit.
Okay, sure. I can put you in touch with one of his press team members.
Oh, well, I would really like to get a hold of Mr. Grassley himself. Is it? Sorry, what was your name?
Sure, they would be able to find out, you know, where he is or set something up to, you know, set up an interview or a conversation with him.
So that's the best thing, yeah. So what was your name, sorry?
This is Emily.
Emily, thank you, Emily. That sounds like a plan, yeah. If you want to go ahead on that basis, please, yeah.
Yep, just a minute.
Yes, that sounds like a cunning plan. Oh, what music have we got here? There we go.
This is Beth.
Hello?
Hi, this is Beth.
Hi, Beth. This is Thomas J. Clark, phoning from the BBC.
Hi.
Oh, I'm phoning from the UK, yes. What I was wanting to do was to get Chuck on for an interview. Talking about a few things. I spoke to Emily there, and she was saying it's best to speak to one of these press guys. I take it that this would be mm-hmm. yourself.
Yep.
Yeah, would it be available?
When are you looking to talk with him?
Well, I'm flexible because what we can do a pre-rec, we can just record it and put it out as whenever. So I'm totally flexible for yourself, Beth. Or Chuck, even.
Well, are you talking today, tomorrow, next week?
Today would be good. Even next week also, yeah, whatever. You tell me, Beth, what you can schedule the senator in with me. I'm good to go. Obviously, there's a bit of a delay.
This week I won't work because he's getting ready to leave to head back home to Iowa.
All right, okay.
So I can't do anything this week, but I can maybe try and arrange for something next week.
Certainly, yeah, definitely. What's the roundabout the
Would
best time?
Would you mind sending me an email?
Yeah, certainly, yeah.
I think that would be the easiest. And then with exactly what you want to talk to him about.
Yeah.
And then we can try and work it that way.
Well, I've managed to get it through the contact information, so I've got the email stuff here. So I write it for the attention of yourself, Beth. Will that get to you through the
yes,
email?
That's great.
What's your full name then? Sorry.
It's Beth, and my last name's Levine. Levine.
Beth Levine. Brilliant, Beth. That'll be brilliant. And I'll send it forward then.
Okay.
And hopefully we can get something for next week.
Okay, sounds great.
Take care, bye-bye.
Thanks, we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so we now work for the BBC. They are the BBC, the British bum cream. Right. No, we're actually, what can we call ourselves? But, what can it be? Right, we use Ordain here. Gonny Bolt, gonny leave me alone. Carol Levine. We've got a Carol Levine, Mike Lee, Patrick Leahy, Patrick G. Leahy, is that an Irish name? Mitch McConnell, Robert Mendez, Bill Nelson, Rand Paul, see now we're talking here, these people might be actually dumb schmucks enough to get me a good few interviews. That's my downside, you know what I mean? I'm going to end up standing on my toes and I'm getting a one-way trip to Guantanamo for a good few years. Just hope the fucking Wi-Fi's good out down in Guantanamo Bay, you know what I mean? We'll get a few shows going there and a bit of orange jumpshoots. A few live exclusive.
Senator Paul's office.
Yes, hello there. I'm phoning to talk to Senator Paul, if possible, please.
He's actually on a radio show right now, but I would be happy to pass along a message to him.
Yeah, certainly. My name's Thomas J. Clark. What's your name yourself?
Brandon.
Brandon, nice to meet you, Brandon. I'm phoning from the BBC, and coincidentally, I want to get Mr. Paul on my radio show.
Well, that works out well, then.
Yeah, cool. Is he on the United States radio just now? What show is he on?
Sean Hannity, I believe.
Oh, my goodness. Sean Hannity? You kid me on that right-wing mad dog?
That's where he's at right now. We're getting calls about it, as a matter of fact.
Sorry?
We're getting calls about his radio show right now, actually.
Oh, right. I'll go and tune in and listen to that later on. Well, hopefully Mr. Paul gives him a good beating then, because I don't like that Sean Hannity at all, mate. I've heard of a few of his radio shows. He's got the voice for radio, but sadly, he's got the face for radio, but sadly I've seen him on the TV, the dumb schmuck, but never mind. Everybody's got
right.
a job to do, haven't they, Brandon? But anyway, listen, is Mr. Paul available to chat then at some point later today, perhaps?
I'm not sure. Let me give you the contact information for his communications director, and you can contact her to set up any interviews or anything like that.
Certainly, my man. That's good.
Would email work for you?
Phone, mate. Phone, Brandon. All the way phone, yeah.
Okay,
Hello?
Yeah, his communications director is Maura Bagley.
Maura, yeah.
Moira.
Yeah.
Bagley.
Brilliant.
Yeah, and her email is just her name, Maura Bagley, separated by an underscore. So Maura_Bagley@paul.senate.gov.
Yeah. Have you got a phone number?
You could just call this office and we could transfer you to her whenever she's available.
Is she available just now then, Brandon, or?
No, because of the radio show.
Right, got you. So would you reckon then should I phone back? Is it better trying later on this evening or maybe even next week now? Probably be better.
Yeah, next week would probably be better because we typically leave the office around 5:30 or 6.
Yeah, got you. It's getting around about that time now. So what day is good to get Mr. Paul? Is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, any time around about then? Or?
I don't know of any specific days. Like I said, the best way to figure that out would just be to contact Maura and she'd be happy to set up an interview.
Brilliant. Okay then, Brandon. I'll leave it like that then.
Excellent. Thank you for your call. We appreciate it.
All the best. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Right, we're going to do one last call. This is quite good here. We're doing this. Right, we're doing this one. Doing this for our good Lithuanian brother. And hail, hail to the Lithuanian brother. The Don Curly Willy of Rutherglen. Here we go.
Good afternoon, Senator Blumenthal's office. I may help.
Yeah, hi. I'm phoning to speak to Richard Blumenthal, please.
And who is calling, sir?
My name is Thomas J. Clark from the BBC in London.
Thomas
J. Clark.
Okay,
the third.
And in what regards?
Yes, I'm phoning to speak, Senator, regarding British-American relations and also the fiscal budget and maybe some stuff about, you know, the improving an economic environment and such like.
Okay. I cannot directly patch you to the senator. However, you can speak to one of the correspondents.
Yeah, please. Media. Yeah, basically, I'm looking to do an interview with the senator at some point. So yeah, if you can put me through to one of these media people. So what was your name, my friend?
Excuse me, can you say that again if you don't mind? You broke up a little bit.
What's your name, sorry?
My name is Joseph.
Joseph, yeah. If you can pass me through to one of these media people, Joseph, I would appreciate
it.
Yeah,
of course. Yeah, just one moment. I just want to see who would be the best for that. One second.
Yeah, from.
Okay, hold on one moment, sir.
Thanks, Joseph. Very important. Very important you get a person's name. I like to be personal. It's nice to know someone's name when you're talking to them. Always attempt to get that, even if it's just for a few seconds. Nice to be nice, you know what I mean? Nice to be nice. Instead of saying, here you, Jimmy.
Sir?
Hello, sir, yeah.
Hi, right now, Kamara, who is our chief of media.
Yeah?
Sorry, press secretary of media. She is not available right now, so do you mind if I transfer you to her voicemail? Is that okay? And then she should get back to you?
Please, thank you, Joseph. Yeah.
Yes, no problem.
Take care. God bless.
To send your message, press 1. To send your message as urgent, press 2. To re-record your message, press 3. To review your message, press 4. To append to your message, press 5. To transfer to the operator, press 0. To cancel this message and exit, press star.
Hi, it's Thomas J.
Sorry,
Clark.
I didn't get that. Please try again. To send your message, press 1. To
send
your message
one.
As urgent, press 2. To re-record your... Thanks, your message was sent. Thanks for calling. Goodbye.
What? Who's that all about? I'm there. Re-record. I might press re-record. Oh, fucking heck. Right, Senator Blumenthal. I've just stumbled onto the representatives now. This has just gone global here. Look at the amount of numbers I've got. Illinois. There's a vacancy. Jesse Jackson Jr. in Illinois. Is he leaving? Jesse Jackson. Jesse Jackson Jr. God, his numbers here are getting down. Right here, that's enough. Enough's enough. Get to his peace. Sorry for not getting enough people on here. Right, I'll phone you. I'll do a show later on, right? I'll do a show later. It's an hour. Look. Half an hour into an hour. Bolt your rockets. We'll do one later on. Great. God bless. We're on the hunt for Chuckles. Chuckles Green, we might speak to Chuckles Green. Where is he? Where is the shyster? All we're asking for is Chuckles Green. We want your number, Chuckles. We want you. We'll get you. We might speak to you. Right. Hey, Ernie boy. Tweet him on tweet, so they put a tweet on. Well done. Yeah, we're leaving it now, we're finishing up. Somebody's put something on the Twitter. We're Radio Goo Goo. Right. We're out of here. Speak to you later. Good night, God bless. Catch you all later.